Hi students, welcome back to my YouTube channel RSK Competitive World. Myself Deepa Koppal, Department of Physics. Students, in this video we are going to study about the gravitation chapter for your BSc first semester. So let us discuss about the gravitation. When I drop a ball, why it falls down? This is because due to the earth is pulling it down with some invisible force. Okay, when I drop a ball, it is coming towards the earth because the earth is pulling down, that is with the invisible force. That invisible force is known as what? Gravity. So that invisible force is known as gravity. The earth pulls all the objects. The earth pulls all the objects. That is how we are standing on the ground or sitting on the ground. We know that here there is a earth, moon and a sun. Okay, so the moon pulls the earth and the sun pulls the moon. This is also, all the other planets also pulls with a invisible force, which is known as a gravitational force, So that is what invisible force is known as, gravitational force. You know that in the universe, all the bodies will pull each other due to because of the gravitational force. So the gravitational force is always attractive. The gravitational force is always attractive because see, if the body is which is attracted towards the another body, the one particle in the universe is which is attracted towards the other particle. So the gravitational, due to this gravitational force, the always this one is attractive. So let us consider that is the force is directly proportional to the product of the masses. The force is always proportional to the masses. For example, you can consider here. See, the one particle of a mass is m1 and the another particle of a mass is m2. So which is having a 1 newton force? 1 newton force. The particle of mass m1 and the particle of mass m2, which is having a force, that is equal to what is force m1 and m2, which is 1 newton. Okay, again you can add the masses here. That is 2m1 and here this is m2. What is the value of force? What is the value of force? Force is equal to the product of masses, means 2 into 1 is 2, 2 newton. 2m1 into m2, that is what? 2n, that is the force is acting here, that is 2n. Next, if you add the another particle of a mass here, that is the for a m2, this is what? 3m2. What is the product of masses here? The F is equal to, the force is equal to the product of masses. 2 into 3 is what? 6. 6 newton. So what it means, means it is the force is the directly proportional to the product of masses. What is force is directly proportional to the product of masses means, when the force is increases, the masses, mass also increases. If the particle of mass is increasing, the force also changes, or the force also increases. So it is what the first case. The force is directly proportional to the masses. When the particle of a mass is increasing, the according to that the force is also increases. This is first case. And the second one is what? The force is proportional to the 1 by distance square. The force is inversely proportional to square of the distance. So how it will be? If you considering that is the, there is a two masses here, and here there is the addition of masses 3m2. So what about the force? That is force is 6 newton. So this is the original original force. So the distance is separated by the r. So the distance is separated by the two body of a masses, that is r. If you increasing the distance, if you increasing the distance, that is 2r, if you increasing the distance, that is 2r, then what will be the force? So the original force is 6n, the original force is 6n. Then if you increasing the radius, means 2r, here there is a 1 by 2r square, means 1 by 4r square, means which is a 1 by 4, 4 times of a force. So in, if you increasing the radius, if you increasing the distance, that is 2r, then we will get the original force is equal to 6n times of 1 by 4 times of 6n, means how much? The 1 by 4 times of 6 newton, means which is 1.5 newton, means if you increasing the distance, then the force will be reduces, the force will be less. Again you can consider, if you decreasing the distance, if you decreasing the distance, that is, this is what a body of mass 2m1 3m2, then if you decreasing, means r by 2 you can consider. If you decreasing the distance, what happens? The original force, that is a 6n, original force is 6n. What is the decreasing radius? R by 2 you can put here. R by 2 means r square by 4. That 4 will go numerator. That the force into 4 times. The 4 times of the force will be, the force is equal to the 4 times of original force, means that is 6 force are 24 newton. If you decreasing the force, then the if you decreasing the distance between the two body of a mass, the force will be increases, means which is inversely. If you increasing the force, the distance will be increases. If you increasing the force, the distance will be reduces. If you decrease the distance here, the force will be high. For example, that is, this is the original, that is 6n newton having a mass 2m1 and 3m2. See here, there is a, if you increasing the distance between the two body of a masses, if you increasing the distance between the two masses, the increasing the distance and the force will be very high. If you decreasing the distance between the two masses, the force will be very less. See here, this is the force is decreasing the distance, the force is very high. Increasing the force, then distance, increasing the distance, the force will be very less. So this is what the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance, means this is, these are the two cases. By using these two cases, we are considering, that is, the force is equal to, force is proportional to masses divided by distance square, means the F is directly proportional to M1, M2 and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two particles. So this equation is what? The Newton's law of gravitation. So the statement is given by every particle in universe attracts every other particle with a force which is directly proportional to the product of masses and inversely proportional to square of their distance between two particles. This is the statement for Newton's law of gravitation, which is given by this equation. That equation, now we have to introduce the proportionality constant between this. So that constant is given by the F is equal to G M1 M2 divided by R square. That G indicates that the universal gravitational constant. This G is what? A universal gravitational constant. That is given by the universal gravitational constant, which is given by, that is G is equal to 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton meter square by kg square. How this G will be having a Newton meter square by g square unit means, you can transfer this equation, that is G is equal to, that is F R square divided by M1 and M2. The F is Newton, R square is meter square divided by M1, M2 is kg square. So this is given by, which is given by, that is Newton meter square per kg square, or you can write it as Newton meter square by kg square, which is also written as Newton meter square per kg square. So this is the constant value the scientist were get this value, that is G is equal to 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. This is the universal gravitational constant, that is G. And the next one is what? Escape velocity. So what is mean by escape velocity? The minimum velocity with which an object must projected from the surface of Earth, so that it escapes from gravitational attraction of Earth is known as escape velocity. See here, considering here there is a Earth here, okay, and the object which is on the Earth, which is having initial velocity u, the object is thrown into the space. Then at a some point it will the stops, that becomes V is equal to 0. So here there is a kinetic energy starting, that is half mv square, and after the reaching the point of this, it becomes the potential energy, that is having gmm by r, that is what a potential energy. So here if you escape the object from the surface of the Earth, escape velocity means what? We have to give the velocity to the object which will escape from the Earth surface. So after escaping the Earth surface, at a certain point it will be stops, and again it is coming back towards the Earth. So whatever we have to give the velocity to the object, that must be very high. If that is a very high, means it is escapes from the Earth surface and it will never come back to the Earth again. So that is mean by escape velocity. So if we given a high velocity to the object, it is thrown into the space, it is never come back again. That is what a escape velocity. So we are considering here there is the kinetic energy and the potential energies that becomes equal at this point, which is given by G M M by R. So here for a mass of the earth, that is a MEM, so that is a GM minus GMEM by R. So this is minus because we don't know the point where it stops, that is from this point to towards the earth, means that is becomes a potential energy becomes minus. So this is the escape velocity for VE. We have to write this M and M get cancels. VE square is equal to GME divided by R. Then VE square, here there is a 2ME, this 2 GME divided by R. V square is equal to, consider there is a, we know that here, that is acceleration due to gravity is given by GM by R square. So V is equal to root of 2GME by R, so which is equal to GM by R square, means here GM by R square means multiply R by R, means 2 R is remaining here, only 1 R, and GM by R square is equal to G, means the escape velocity is given by escape velocity is given by that is root of 2 GR. See here, the kinetic energy becomes equal to the potential energy here. And next, escape velocity, that is V, you can say V square is equal to this 2 GME divided by R. MM get cancels. And V is equal to root of 2 GME by R. Multiply by R by R, because we know that the acceleration due to gravity is equal to GM divided by R square. So multiplying R by R here, then we'll get GM by R square here. So 1 R is remaining, that is escape velocity is given by the square root of 2 GR. This is the escape velocity expression. So escape velocity is given by root of 2 GR. G is the acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity. And R is the radius of the earth. See, this is what a radius of the earth. We can put 6400, and acceleration gravity is equal to 9.8. That is V is equal to 2 into 9.8 into 6400. Then we get here, that is V is equal to root of 2 into 9.8 into 6400, 11.2 kilometer per second. 11.2 kilometer per second escape velocity. We want to escape the body from the, we want to escape the object from this earth surface. We have to give the value of 11.2 kilometer per second, the escape velocity. We have to give that object and it will escapes from the surface of the earth. So this 11.2 is for earth, and for Mercury planet, the escape velocity is how much? 4.2 kilometer per second. Mercury planet is for 4.2 kilometer per second. For Jupiter, it's 61 kilometer per second. This is the very high escape velocity of 61 kilometer per second for Jupiter. This is 61 kilometer. 11.2 is for Earth. 4.2 is for Mercury planet. And for Sun, 618 kilometer per second. 618 kilometer per second. This is escape velocity for a Mercury, Jupiter, Sun, and this one is the Earth. So the next one is orbital velocity. What is mean by orbital velocity? Which is defined as the velocity at which a body, the velocity at which a body or a satellite, body or a satellite revolves around the other body. A velocity at which a body or the satellite which revolves around the other body. You can consider Earth, other body means you can consider Earth or any other planet. Other planet. If a one body is revolving around the other body, which having a velocity, which velocity is known as a orbital velocity. So you can consider this one is the Earth, which is having a radius r. And if you escape the body from the Earth surface, means which is having some velocity, that velocity, by that velocity it is escapes the Earth surface. And it is what, if you given a small amount of velocity, it is escapes from the Earth, again it will falls like this. Again another high of velocity you given, it is escapes from the Earth and it's falling like this again to the Earth surface. And if you given a minimum velocity, that which be escapes from the Earth surface and which is revolving around the Earth, that is known as the orbital velocity. Orbital velocity, which is, if you taken the satellite which is launching from the Earth surface, if you given a minimum velocity which is escapes from the Earth surface and which revolving around the Earth surface, which is not come back towards the Earth surface, that is known as the orbital velocity. Okay, so that orbital velocity, you have an expression for the orbital velocity which indicated that V naught for orbital velocity. And see here, if the body is revolving around the Earth surface, means which is having a centripetal force, that is mv square by r, and the gravitational force, the Earth which is having a gravitational force, that is gmm divided by r square. So when the centripetal force is balanced by the gravitational force, you have mv square by r is equal to gmm divided by r square. So here there is a r and r will get cancels, and m will get cancels because of orbital velocity. We are considering v naught square here, gm divided by r. So v naught is equal to root of square root of gm by r. We can multiply r by r because we know that g is equal to gm divided by r square. So that is gm by r square means g, and another one r is gr. That is orbital velocity is given by square root of gr. We know that escape velocity, that is what, escape velocity is square root of 2 gr. But what about the orbital velocity? Root square root of gr. We can write it as a v naught is equal to v divided by root 2, because v is a square root of 2 gr and v naught is the square root of gr. That's why the v naught is equal to v escape velocity divided by root 2, means root 2 get cancels, only remaining square root of gr. So we have to calculate the velocity of the orbital, that is orbital velocity. We know that VE, how much, 11.2 divided by root 2, means 11.2. So V naught is equal to 11.2 divided by here 1 by root 2 is into 0.707, because root 2 is 1.14 and 1 by 1.14 is 0.707, which is equal to 7.92 kilometer per second. This is orbital velocity. What about escape velocity? Escape velocity is 11.2 kilometer per second. Then the orbital velocity is 7.92 kilometer per second. So the orbital velocity is less than the escape velocity. So this is about the orbital velocity, and the orbital velocity of satellite revolving around the at a height h. See here, this is what R, this is R, and this is H. You can consider the satellite revolving around the Earth surface. This is H. You can consider the this H plus R. So orbital velocity is given by square root of gr. So what about r here? R is r plus h, because if we given, if asked the satellite, the orbital velocity of satellite revolving around the Earth surface, if you asked r plus h, the expression is given by r plus h, or you can write it as square root of gm divided by r plus h. These two equations are very, very important for solving the problems. The orbital velocity is given by which the satellite is revolving around the Earth surface. That is what g in the bracket r plus h and gm divided by r plus h. This is about the orbital velocity, escape velocity, and the Newton's law of gravitation. So the students do the study, and the next concept we will discuss in the next session. Thank you so much, and please subscribe my channel, then you will get all the videos in that channel. So please give the like and subscribe the channel and share to your friends. Thank you, students.